Hi there, welcome back to Fab Trends by Mia. Thank you so much for tuning in. So as you can see from the title, yes, I'm quite excited to share this list. And do you know what? I said to myself, I'm going to share this list because I feel like if I share the list, then I'll be more committed and more disciplined in getting through my list. Because over the years, what's happened is at the beginning of the year, I tell myself, this is what's going to happen. And guess what? As we carry on, I end up getting so many fragrances, which I didn't plan to buy. So I'm hoping I'm going to be so disciplined, like things change. So yes, today's video is all about my top 10 fragrance wish list for 2020. Yes, I know we are in May, but still, we've still got half the year to go. So I'll get on with it and let's get into this list. Have you guessed, those who know me, do you have any guesses what you think might be on the list? Please do let me know in the comments section if at all you've guessed one or two correct, or you know, you just let me know. I would love to hear from you. And also, share your list. What's on your list? What fragrances are you looking forward to? Let's get into this.
I'ma flex on my ex, flex on a hoe. You still be in my ass, so I'ma let you know. I realize how much I want.
Right. Top 10 fragrance wish list 2020. At number 10, by the way, the numbers are this is in no particular order, so I won't be following this exact order in acquiring the fragrances, but I had to count them down. So at number 10 we have New York Intense, and this is from Nicolai Perfumers. So this, again, oh my gosh, I had a sample sent to me. And this is from one of my fragrance sisters of Instagram, Han. Yes, Han. She sent me some samples, and Nicolai Intense, New York Intense was one of them. And also she sent me a Patchouli Intense. And do you know what? I will be doing reviews on those fragrances, so I won't go into too much details until I'll do a video especially to review those fragrances. But it's a lovely, masculine, confident fragrance, and I'm so excited. And this, again, when my husband tried it, he was like, oh wow, this is nice. So I was like, okay, I'll add it to the list. So it's his choice, so looking forward to that. Moving along, we come to number 9. At number 9, we have Desert Rosewood, and this is from Godfield and Banks, Australia. And this fragrance is a lovely, ambery, leathery fragrance, and it's got some ouds and benzoin. Oh my gosh, I love this fragrance. I did a review of it. Check it out, because I don't know, have you tried this fragrance? I think it's an amazing fragrance. Moving along on my list, we come to number 8. Number 8, we have Grape Pearls. Have you seen the bottle? I so want that fragrance. Actually, I do want it, and I'm hoping next time I'll be out somewhere where they sell it, I'll pick it up. But Grape Pearls from the House of Oud is on my list and comes in at number 8. A lovely, fruity, musky, gourmand fragrance. I'm looking forward to that. The bottle is stunning. What's not to like? Gorgeous fragrance. Moving along, we come to number 7. At number 7, this is a fragrance I actually spoke about wanting to add this fragrance in the list I did for 2018 Christmas wish list. I didn't get it up to now. I know it's terrible, isn't it? But I'm getting there. Like, this is what I said, I need to discipline myself, because I've since gone on to buy probably hundreds of fragrances and still didn't get that one. So anyway, I'm gonna get to it. And this is none other than Delina from Perfumes Damali. Yes. Oh my gosh, I can't wait. I love that fragrance. I've smelled it in store quite a few times. And as well, I love the bottle. It's so me. I can't wait. So, Delina exclusives, if I can. Anyway, moving along, we come to number 6. At number 6, again, a fragrance I've spoken about on here. I think I've spoken quite a fair bit about this fragrance. I've done a full review as well. I'll link the video down on in the comments section below, and this is none other than, I'll try and describe the fragrance and let's see if you can guess, since I've done a review of this fragrance. So this fragrance, it's a lovely citrus fragrance, lovely citrus opening. There's some lemon, some bergamot, and then you do get pineapples. Yes, I'm giving away now. You have oak moss, there's patchouli, gorgeous. And you know what, for a summer fragrance, or rather a citrus fragrance, this fragrance is got beast mode performance. I'm not even joking. Did you guess? Yeah, I'll put you out of your misery. Yes, this is none other than Hasivat from the house of Nishane. And yes, and do you know how much I love Nishane? And they've done obviously one of my top fragrances for life. Yes, and yes, and I can't wait for Anne to have a brother or sister in the collection. So Nishane, we've got Hasivat, looking forward to that. Moving along, we come to number five. At number five, again, a fragrance I spoke about very recently, and this is a fragrance I fell in love with at first sniff. Can you guess? This is a very gorgeous ambery fragrance. Like, oh my god, so sensual. I want that fragrance. Performance, projection, everything, you name it, it's got it going. Did you guess? Yes, amber, absolutely. I can't wait to get that amber amazing fragrance in my collection. Moving along, we come to number five. At number five, this is a fragrance from a house I've fallen in love with, like fallen nose over heels. Yes, and this is again a fragrance that's not for inexperienced noses. This is a fragrance art. You appreciate fragrances, you want this fragrance. You must at least just smell it. This is a fragrance, and again, this fragrance is even on this list because my husband is falling in love with this house. Like, they are masterpieces, to be honest, deservingly so to be on this list. At number five, we have, did you guess? Yes, it's from Allège Ledo, and this is Siberian Summer. Bring it, oh, come to mama. Moving along, we come to number three. At number three, this is a fragrance, and again, a fragrance I smelled very, very recently. Like, I got this fragrance, if you saw my video when I did the unboxing of Rila's Casamorati. Yes, so I unboxed this beauty, and with this purchase came some samples. So I got a sample pack. Yes, so we got a sample pack from Zedge of Universe. And with this sample pack, oh, that's what we had. And yes, came this fragrance, Rila's 1888 from the Casamalata line. So, oh my gosh. I'm just gonna show you the box. Anyway, when I smelled this fragrance, I was like, oh my god, where have you been? Why did I not smell this fragrance before? I want it, like, I want it yesterday. Yes, come to mama. I can't wait to add this beauty to my collection. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous oriental floral. You've got some coriander, some carnation, peppers, saffron, you've got rose neroli, you've got ylang ylang, there's some sandalwood, patchouli, amber, and as well we've got beech. Oh my gosh, I can't wait for this fragrance to be in my collection. Moving along, oh, things are heating up. I'm even getting hot. I'm getting hot. This list is so hot. We get to number two. At number two, can you guess which two other fragrances I would like to add to my collection? I give you a clue. I've spoken about them before. At least one of them I've spoken about. I've done a review of it on my channel. Did you guess? Yes. This is none other than Baccarat Rouge 540, and this is the Extrait de Parfum. So I'm so excited. I love that fragrance. I had the sample. I did a review before, and the sample is literally right at the bottom, and I can't wait to add the bottle because that fragrance is gorgeous. I just need that bottle in my life. And do you know what is the other clue to that fragrance? And possibly another reason why I'm gonna get the extract. It's red. Yes. Baccarat Rouge 540. Gorgeous ambery fragrance as well. I can't wait. I've spoken about this. I'm gonna link all the necessary videos that I've mentioned down below in the comment section, so do check them out. And we come to the end. At number one, what other fragrance am I looking forward to? What's on my list? Actually, at number one is not even one fragrance. To be honest, I might get a few from this house because I have at least three that are on my immediate to buy list from this house. Can you guess? I have fallen nose over heels this fragrance. Like, oh my god, they do amazing fragrances. The presentation, the packaging, everything. The smell of the fragrance is so divine, luxurious. I can't wait. What's that fragrance? I'll put you out of your misery. This is none other than Santo Complete, and this is from the House of Fragrance Dubois. Oh my gosh, have you seen their presentation? I don't have anything out. Oh, I don't have anything out at the moment. The boxes are behind me, but I've done reviews, so do check them out. I'm gonna link videos down below. So this Santo Complete, and this is a vanilla oriental fragrance, and it's got notes of lemon, coconut, you've got in the mid violet, black pepper, and then in the base there's some musk, sandalwood, amber and vanilla. Screams my name. I've actually sampled this one at Jovoy, so looking forward to add that to my collection. Coconut, lemon, violet, sandalwood, vanilla. Oh, match made in heaven. Bring it on. Come to mama. What's on your list? Do share in the comments down below. I'm gonna do my best to try and work through this list. At the end of the year, I will revisit this and see how I've done. So stay tuned to Fab Trends by Mia. And thank you so much for watching if you watched to the end. Keep smelling good. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I shall see you in the next one. Take care. Bye.